As we dig into the history of the school, the first question we answer is how it started. While on ground, we learned that a man only referred to as Mr. Tom, the director of the school and a retired Uganda wildlife staff, is the mastermind behind Mpondwe Lubiriha Secondary School. We learned that he managed to convince children to join the school, as the parents narrate. As parents, we were never asked for our children. He gathered our children from the centers, convinced them to join the school. We tried to stop them, but they refused to listen to us. Initially, my son Marius Kule was studying at Muhokia. A man came and convinced them to go to Nyabuganda to play football. He refused to return to his former school. He linked up with the man who took them to Nyabuganda. We have never heard from this man ever again.
My son was not a student at that school. He studied at Wera Alliance. Towards the start of their second term, he informed me about his decision to change school to where he would get a bursary. He said the school would pay half of the fees since they are football players. He said they had already reached the school, met the headmaster, and come to an agreement. I told my wife to let the boy be. I told her it was up to him. My role would be to pay half the school fees.
The school first started from Muhindi village in Nachiyumbu sub-county. Then it was called Peter Hunter's Secondary School. This was a local setting but also had most of the people that were supposed to be direct beneficiaries.
School initially started in Nachiyumbu sub-county in a place called Muhindi. It had sponsors from Wua. Even Tom himself, he was a staff working with Wua. Then after him retiring from Wua, he came and established that project of Peter Hunt Secondary School in Muhindi. So in Muhindi, the school didn't do well because it was in a remote area and they did not be able to get enough students as they wished. So they had to transfer from Muhindi to Nyabuganda, where they had acquired land. Now resettled in Nyabuganda. And by then we hear, even when the school had established itself in Nyabuganda, they had a challenge of lacking students. So what they used the method of tracking students from other areas by telling them that they are going to sponsor them as well as they play football to market that school, so that they attract big numbers of students. That was their main motive why they mobilized the footballers and netballers.
William Baluko, a 62-year-old native of Nyabugandu cell, arrived in the village in 1974. Besides the horrible events of the fateful day, Baluko has a clear image of how the school began in their village after shifting from Muhindi village. His home is about 250 meters from Mpondwe Lubiriha Secondary School.
School started in 2014. It was brought by a man. He called these poachers that he's coming to give them development, so they should stop going hunting animals in the park. Then after that, said, let me help you. You stop hunting, you bring the children here, they study from here, and after school, maybe they will help you.
Shortly after the school had settled in the new location, the director changed the name of the school to Mpondwe Lubiriha Secondary School. This caused tension between the director and the hunters, who started withdrawing their children from the school.
When they started it, it was called Peter Hunter Secondary School. So that was the misunderstanding which was there. And why they called it a Peter Hunter, it was started by the hunters.
The hunters, they were not even in this village. Others came from Mundongo, others from Mushenene, and some from Kamkumbi down there. They bought this land here that they are going to make a development, which will enable them not to be going to poach the animals in the park. The director didn't have a sense of promoting that school because he was eating money. He cannot even pay the teachers. Then the teachers left the school. After that, the children also left the school.
According to the community, the school always had a population of 60 to 70 students every time it was running. George Mainja, the principal district education officer who refused to get on camera, insisting that the matter was a police issue, later revealed that the school was registered under the Ministry of Education and Sports as a secondary day school, but it operated as a day and boarding school.
The school is registered and there is a certificate of registration, yes, from Ministry of Education and Sports. Another lesson is that it takes time for heads or owners of schools to be compliant.
One of the survivors and a brother-in-law to the director of the school, who was in the school during the attack, says he was about to start his vocational training at the institution. He stayed in the store that was next to the girls' hostel. We asked the Kasese resident district commissioner whether they had had prior intelligence concerns about the school.
Let me call it a school. It was maybe the stage managed the donors to come and they see that we have a school, because they claim that it once had 600, but if you look what the structures or the building there, it cannot accommodate the 600 that they claim. The 70 plus they are talking about, people were not even from Pondu, they were coming from very far, which means that these people just had on their own intentions.
Report by Rogers Akanyijuka, Ivan Senyonjo, and Stuart Yiga for the news.